frustration. We come here peaceful to present our petition to the national executive. But after the 1 week, if we didn't hear anything, our next line of action is, we have told them we are not going to participate in the limited registration that is oncoming. We will not participate. We, the branches that we have insist that we are going to hear the true state of the NDC in Odododiodio. If we didn't hear the true state of NDC in Odododiodio, we are not going to participate in the limited registration. That is one. And we'll make sure that we'll come here to make a very big demonstration that the national cannot contain our numbers. We'll make it very big, and they will be surprised what they are seeing.
Please subscribe to Morris TVGH.
Ordinary member asks you, as a branch among branches, what is your problem? Can you be able to explain to the person so that he can also calm down? And we are, when we always ask, no response. So we, the branches, that sign our signatures, and we are more than 100 and something branches. We are petitioned to the national executives. If our consortium election is not being held, then we are advising ourselves not to participate in the national limited registration that come in on.
That's all.
That is the reason why we are.
We are so grateful.
Thank you.
Ezu.
Eza.
Eza.
Ezu.
Ezu.
Eza.
We are grateful that you came.
Yes.
All right. Like I said, the national chairman is not here.
Okay.
The general secretary is not here.
Of course, can I make you?
But I'm the deputy general secretary. And I think that it is right for us to address you.
Okay.
Your concerns are very legitimate.
Yes.
They are very right. It's within your right as party members to want to know the fate of your constituents.
Thank you.
We ourselves, under the leadership of the General Secretary, are committed to completing the primaries throughout the country so that we can all hit the road to campaign. What happened is that we are left with 18 constituencies to finish the whole country. Out of the 18, we divided them into two, the southern zone and then the northern zone. The northern zone is the Ashanti region, eastern region, and if you recall, last week, they did theirs. So the next trip, or the next lap, has to do with Greater Accra, central region, northeastern region, and western region, if they are ready. So no one would want to refuse to do your primaries when it is due. But what it is that it falls in a category or a batch. And that I think in a week's time, when General Secretary comes, we'll discuss it and we'll get to know your timetable. So we are not sitting down. We are here to work for the country. We are here to ensure that we all work to bring your Mahama back as a president.
Exactly.
Don't allow anybody to deceive you.
Thank you. Yes.
We are not here to serve interests of parliamentarians, parliamentary candidates, or aspirants.
Yes.
We are here for one cause, your business, and the business of making your Mahama the president.
Thank you, sir.
The problem is resolved. Deciding not to participate in the limited registration. It's like when a thief has entered your house and you are fighting with your wife and you decide you won't mind the thief, he will steal you and go. When your conflict is over, you will not find the property that you left. Do you understand?
Yes.
So we will resolve the problem. It should not be enough for us to allow the MPP to misbehave.
Yes.
We should go out there and get our numbers to register. Because whether you agree with parliamentary or not, you cannot survive under MPP.
No,
that's never, never, never.
They are criminals and they have come to steal.
Yes, yes.
And so if you decide you won't do limited registration, what will happen is that our people, yourself, myself, will not get to vote. If we don't vote, we will not win the election.
Yes.
So whilst we fight internally, let's focus on the external issues. But on behalf of the National Chairman and the General Secretary, we are very happy to see all of you.
Thank you.
It's because you are committed to the cause of the party. We'll do what makes you happy, so that we can all be happy.
Yes.
So we thank you so much for not taking the law into your hands,
yes,
but just realizing that you need to come to your party to demonstrate or to present a petition. I'll read the petition. We'll take the numbers of your leadership and we'll contact him and the constituency going forward for our issues and matters. Thank you so much.
The issue is that the way you explain to us now the Odododiodio as executives, as a branch executive, as a hard-working people for Odododiodio, we can see we are now going to brief our people. Because since this limited registration, reorganization scam, and we heard that the nomination has been open for parliamentary candidates, all of a sudden, Odododiodio was suspended. No one, including our sitting MP, no one came to us, organized word by word, explained to us why is it that the reason why we have been suspended. And later we heard that 11, only 16 or 18, as we said. And later in the day, we heard that they have been given others to even vote. Amasaman, for instance, example like this, we heard Amasaman was having a big problem, but the national executive solved it and they voted. Ayawaso was left, the whole Greater Accra, it was left with only Ayawaso and Odododiodio. As I'm speaking to you now, Ayawaso has also been solved. But as for Odododiodio, and our worry is that we have been divided in the constituency, as I'm speaking to you, by the candidates who are contested. And we are going to do the limited registration with this division. Can it be possible? So I'm coming on, I will let me learn. So at the end of the day, and this wicked woman called Jane Adukwe Mensa, she's saying that she's not going to do it, she's going to do it district level. It means that the branch executive, we have to work hard, convene our people to that district level. And who is going, are you going to call based on candidature? Or we will have a leader before doing this. So that's our concern.
So the good thing is that,
yes,
like I told you,
yeah,
no one can manipulate this leadership.
Perfect.
No one.
Thank you very much.
And like you rightly said,
yeah,
if there are problems and we don't manage the problems, we are supposed to manage to win the election for the NDC. If there are problems, we will not play into the MPP's hands.
Yes.
We'll resolve our issues and do the primaries, so that MPP will not take advantage to divide the constituency.
Yes, yes.
So since you acknowledge that there are even problems in the country, it's the same reason why we've been managing the problem. The rest are sure that it is not about your candidate, it's not about anybody's candidate, it's not about your MP, it's not about any constituency executive. It's about national's plan of action. None of them have influenced this election. It's our own timetable that we are working on. Like I told you, the remaining 8 will be done. And inshallah, I believe that today we have a meeting. We'll resolve on all of those issues. And then like I said, your leader, you are the leader. So we'll take your number, we'll take my number. By the close of the day, we should get you a feedback. What is very important is that when you are not happy, you are able to speak to it. And we are able to respond to you. That is the good thing about where we find ourselves. Take the assurance that whether we register at the district or register at municipal, we will win 2024. And we count on all of you to make that dream possible.
Yes.
For we cannot win alone. John Mahama cannot win alone.
Yes.
It is us who work on the ground for the victory to come. So we don't play with you at all. That is why I have come to listen to you. And rest assured that the problem will be solved.
Thank you.
Honorable, that is the last question.
Yeah. How true? Go
ahead. No, let you ask after.
Honorable, please. How true is it that a research has been conducted in Odododiodio? National has sent a team to conduct a research in Odododiodio. And based on that research, a particular candidate is being allowed to go into our parliamentary elections, even though the person is a defectee.
The guidelines of the NDC is not based on research.
Yes.
The guideline of the NDC is based on election. And our guidelines are also based on what our constitution says.
Thank you very much.
If you are qualified, you will contest. If you are not qualified, you won't contest.
Thank you.
So, okay. If anybody is talking to you about a guideline, a research. Research do not produce our parliamentary candidates. What produces parliamentary candidates is the constitution. If you qualify, you go for vetting. If you go for vetting, they do election. If you are qualified, if God bless and you win, you win.
You win,
and
yes.
If you lose, you lose. That is how it works.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
So I wish you all the best.
Yeah.
Who has a pen?
Yes,
so take my number.
And so far as you be a leader of a party in a community, there will be a pressure on you through your people. Our branch members have started asking us the reason why our constituency, we haven't held our election. Once all the constituencies have been held, their elections already. So we, the branch leadership, we cannot explain to our branch members. So anytime we go to the constituency to ask our constituency leadership or the regional leadership, the excuse is the national has been conducted a research in the Odododio. So because of the research, our election is still at hold unless they finish the research. So it has become too much. Anytime you ask, they will say end of this month and the month will end. Anytime end of this month, the month will end. Currently in Odododio, I can confidently say that we don't have executives because we have aspirants, and all the constituency executives have been divided to touch themselves into the aspirants contest. So who is the leader of the party currently in Odododio to tell us what is happening, or can you unite all the branches to come out and make sure that we do this incoming limited registration so that the party can get more souls and make sure that we win the 2024 election. So it is our worry, we as a branch executives, we are not here for any candidate. We are here for ourselves as branch heads of the party in the Odododio. So that's why we are here to petition the headquarters to able to explain to us that this is the reason why our elections have been put on hold, because we didn't have any problem during our reorganizations. Odododio doesn't have any problem. And we finish our constituency elections peaceful. Those who have won, congratulate those who have lost, and those who have lost, congratulate those who have won. And we are now working together. These problems have been dividing us a lot. So we need to do it so that we can come back and build Odododio NDC together.
All right, the secretary.